It's the most wonderful time of the year.
Hi, folks, and welcome back. I know it's been quite a while, a couple of months to say the least. I kind of dropped off the face of the earth yet again. Wishing you a very Merry Christmas and a very Happy New Year, because I doubt I'll see you again until next year, 2018, purely because, as you can see in the background there, that is one piece of my move. I am moving places yet again, and in the midst of that I've picked up a few details about the last semi-place that I'm moving out of, that wasn't too good for my health, so it's good that we're moving, not too good for you guys, but good for me in the long term. We're almost fully moved out, but we're not quite there yet. Hopefully by the New Year's I'll be fully moved in. Almost there, like I said. But tonight it is Feliz Navidad at Movie World. It is White Christmas. I don't expect to be here for a long period of time. I'll probably have the mad rush to the car park yet again, but I don't know if you guys can actually see this. Probably not. But out this way behind you guys is the quick exit to turn and to get the frig out of here. This is the only side entrance open by me driving around, so hopefully we get out of here and we don't have any issues like we have had in the past getting out of White Christmas. I expect everything to be same as last year. Third time in a row, let's have the same parade! Yes! Polar Express came out many, many years ago. I believe it was in my teens when Polar Express came out. So they should really update this parade, but I'm pretty sure they haven't changed it. They should just, in my opinion, if they're going DC World, they might as well chuck some DC Christmas shivers in there. There's plenty to pull from. Give me some Christmas Harley. And some Christmas Joker. Give me that. So it is 4:57 on Sunday the 10th of December. Tomorrow's my dad's birthday, so happy birthday, Dad! I made sure it was his birthday tomorrow and not today, so we're all good! We'll head into Movie World pretty shortly. But I am back for the short term for this video. And then we should be all good to go for 2018. There are some exciting things planned for Dreamworld. So that's a little taste of what might possibly happen next year. So, and there also might be another international holiday for you to join us on. So for the last video, possibly I might do a retrospect of what happened this year. Who knows? This is so rambly. But here we go! Will you join me? Of course you will. We are heading into 29 degree weather and wind into White Christmas and the possible White Christmas that Australia will ever get in the form of soap snow. Join me right now.
Thank you. Thank you.
Christmas party was same, same. Buffet was same, same. Parade was same, same. Maybe they threw in a bit of more dancing, but same, same. There was an article done by Parks Forum, I think last week or the week before, where they spoke to the CEO of Village Roadshow Theme Parks, and they were excited and they were taking people's feedback on desk, using it properly, and that can be seen in no longer locker hires for Superman. So they're listening, just maybe a feedback for White Christmas. Change up the parade. Most people around me left a comment while watching the parade going, what is that? What is Polar Express? Nobody knew what it was. That's how dated it is. So maybe get rid of that whole section. But this is not a negative video. I do enjoy White Christmas over Carnival, which I just can't believe that Carnival is running again next year. It's at SeaWorld again next year. Apparently it's going to be better next year. We'll see if we can go for more than half an hour at Carnival next year. Also, pricing has changed with Village Roadshow. There is no more memberships, no more VIP memberships, VIP passes, magic passes. It is set pricing, which is roughly $200 for 12 months paid up front. So there is a locals discount which brings it down to 160 roughly, but it is still not, I wouldn't say it would be affordable as compared to Dreamworld, especially for those who pay monthly. It's very easy for me. $12 comes out and I get everything. You're now paying 160, so up to $190-$200 for a singular pass, and I understand where it's coming from, and I'm totally on side with people on Parks Forum who agree that it's cutting out the market that they don't want. So it's kind of, I guess you would say, it's similar to how Disney prices. At the moment, Disney has pretty much cut out all the lower class that could possibly ever go to Disney, and that is how I believe Movie World is going. They're going to have their segmented market that they're marketing to, and that will cut out the bottom middle range people, and to focus on new, improved, whatever they're doing next year. So it'll be interesting how that goes forward. Scooby is coming back as well with projection mapping on their people, their animatronics, if you want to call them that. But if this is my last video for 2017, I hope you had a fantastic year. I hope you have a fantastic time with your family and loved ones over the Christmas and New Year period. And we shall see you sometime in 2018. And we'll see you next year. I hope you have a great week, great rest of the year if I don't see you then. And see you on the flip side. Bye, guys.